of visiting dinner with his parents when Rufus Buck and his gang come to their house, gun down his parents and carve a cross into his forehead. 20 years later, an adult Love, now an outlaw, kills one of the gang members in revenge. Meanwhile, his partners, sharpshooter Bill Pickett and quick draw Jim Beckwith, ambush another gang and steal their haul from a recent bank robbery. The lone survivor tells them the $25,000 they have stolen belongs to Buck. Love travels to meet his former lover, Mary Fields, who runs a chain of saloons. Pickett brings news of the heist to Love. Buck's gang, led by Trudy Smith and quick draw Cherokee Bill, retrieve Buck from a train leaving from Yuma, where he had been incarcerated. Arriving in his former stronghold of Redwood City, it's now run by Buck's associate, Wiley Esco. Although left in charge by Buck, Esco has used the position to profit at the expense of the town. Buck beats him, ordering him to leave town. Buck gathers the town people and tells them they will need $50,000 to save the town and proposes a tax to raise that money. He kills a man who objects by accepting the townsfolk cannot raise the full amount. In Field's saloon, Marshal Bass Reeves arrests Love, removing him in handcuffs. The arrest was staged so they can hand down Buck without involving Love's gang. Reeves is angry because Buck has been pardoned, and he knows Love wants revenge. Love's gang, however, accompanied by Fields and her friend Guffy, suspecting a ruse, follow Love and Reeves, insisting on joining. They encounter Esco, who tells them Buck has returned to Redwood. Fields volunteers to scout Redwood under the cover of offering to buy Smith's saloon. The night before she leaves, Love proposes, but she turns him down. When Fields arrives in Redwood, Smith takes her prisoner and beats her, then says she will hold her hostage for a day and then kill her if no one comes to fetch her. Love's gang arrives the same night, but Smith insists he joins Fields in captivity, which he does. Smith has him bitten, then Buck tells him to release Fields. Love will need to rob a bank in Marysville, a white town, and give back the money. Love and Cuffy rob the bank without killing anyone and escape. Reeves and Love agree Buck will not release Mary even if they hand over the money. Esco supplies them with a car full of guns and dynamite. They take the money into Redwood in two cars, one of which is a dummy, both primed with dynamite. After the dummy wagon is destroyed, killing some of Buck's henchmen, Love hands over the money but is stopped from leaving by Cherokee, Bill. Beckwith challenges him to a quick draw contest but is shot and killed by Bill while counting down. A gunfight erupts during which Pickett, Cuffy, Reeves, and Love kill most of Buck's gang and the money is destroyed in another explosion. Esco infiltrates Buck's house with more dynamite but is killed by Buck while Pickett and Love are wounded. Mary is freed by Cuffy and pursues Smith, who she defeats in a hand-to-hand fight. During a lull, Pickett is shot in the back by Bill, who is subsequently killed by Cuffy. Love enters Buck's house but finds him unwilling to defend himself. Instead, Buck tells him about his own parents. His outlaw father killed his mother after a long period of abuse and then abandoned him when he was 10. Buck subsequently hunted his father down, finding he changed his ways and names, and reveals that his father was also Love's. While he killed his father in revenge, he says the real revenge was driving Love into outlawry, and he scared Love's face so that he would recognize him when he saw him again. Love then shoots Buck dead. Love and his companions bury Pickett and Beckwith alongside another grave marked "Not Love." Reeves will report Love as dead, and Cuffy joins Reeves in law enforcement. Mary and Love ride off as Smith looks on from a distance.